Good morning, everybody. Yesterday we discussed quadratic equation formulae basic concepts. Now we'll go for the first exercise in the quadratic equations. First exercise in the quadratic equation. The roots of the equation 4x square plus 2x plus 8 equal to 0 are 4x square plus 2x plus 8 equal to 0 are. The roots of the equation 4x square plus 2x plus 8 equal to 0 are option A, rational and equal, rational and not equal, irrational, imaginary. Means we need to find discriminant value. If the discriminant is greater than or equal to 0, then roots are real and distinct. Less than 0, roots are complex. Equal to 0, roots are real and equal. Equal to 0, roots are real and equal. More than 0, real and distinct. Less than 0, complex. And if b square minus 4ac is a perfect square, then roots are rational. Rational. Now we'll check what is that. So we'll go for b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac, 2 square 4 minus 4ac, 4 4 is 16, 8 ja. 4 4 ja 16. 16, 8 ja 128. 16, 8 ja 128. So I am getting minus 124, means less than 0, means roots are complex or imaginary. Roots are complex or imaginary. So your option is fourth option. Your answer is fourth option. Fourth option. Next, second question. This is the first question. Next, second question. If alpha beta are the roots of the equation, if alpha beta are the roots of the equation, x square plus 6x, x square plus 6x plus 34 equal to 0. X square plus 6x plus 34 equal to 0. Then 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta equal to dash. Then 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta equal to dash. Then 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta equal to dash. Now, x square plus 6x plus 34 equal to 0, alpha beta are the roots. Means we know that sum of the roots alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a, that is minus 6. And alpha beta equal to c by a, 34. Now if I divide this by this, what do I get? Alpha plus beta by alpha beta equal to minus 6 by 34. Minus 6 by 34. Now this is 2 3 jars, 2 17 jars. Now left out here is alpha by alpha beta, 1 by beta, and beta by alpha beta, 1 by alpha, equal to minus 3 by 17. That is only the same. 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta is nothing but minus 3 by 17. That is third option in our exercise. Next, third sum. The minimum value of x square minus 5x plus 6. The minimum value of x square minus 5x plus 6 is asking. Minimum value. I gave you a formula. The minimum value, if a is more than 0, it contains minimum value. A here is 1, more than 0, so it contains 100% minimum value. And the minimum value is 4ac minus b square by 4a. 4ac minus b square by 4a. That is minimum value equal to minimum or maximum. Formula is same, it depends only on the a value I told. A is more than 0, 100% contains minimum value, that is the minimum value. If a is less than 0, it contains maximum value, so you need to find maximum value. Formula is same, 4ac minus b square by 4a. 4ac minus b square by 4a gives you minimum value. Okay. So what is that 4ac minus b square by 4a? That is 4 into 1 into 6. 4 6 are 24 minus b square means 25 by 4a. 4 into 1 4. So minus 1 by 4 is the minimum value. Minus 1 by 4 is the minimum value. So here first option is the answer. And the same next one is maximum value. 5 plus 4x minus 4x square Here a is minus 4. Arrange this in the proper order. Then a is minus 4, b is plus 4, c is 5. So since a is less than 0, it contains maximum value, and the maximum value formula is same, 4ac minus b square by 4a. So same concept you can use. Only thing is, instead of minimum, you have maximum. If you arrange in proper order, minus 4x square plus 4x minus 4x square plus 4x plus 5 is our maximum value. So, as a is less than 0, it 100% contains maximum value, even if he is not asking. So, maximum value is 4ac minus b square by 4a. Now, what is the value of 4ac? 4 into 4, 16, minus 16. 16 by 80, so minus 80. 4ac minus b square is 16. 4ac minus b square by 4a, 4 jar, minus 16. So, now minus 80, minus 16, minus 96 by minus 16. 16, 6 jar, 96. So, maximum value is 6. So, maximum value of the expression is 6. This is again first half only. Next, fifth question. X square minus 4x minus 32 greater than 0, if and only if we just. Next question is, what is asking is, x square minus 4x minus 32. X square minus 4x minus 32 greater than 0. Then he is asking about x value. Now, when is it possible? So you can factorize simply. 4 into 32. So you can write as x square minus 8x plus 4x. Treating the middle of 4x as minus 8x plus 4x. Minus 32 greater than 0. So that I can take x common from these two, this becomes x minus 8. Plus 4 common from these two, x minus 8 greater than 0. Means x plus 4 into x minus 8 greater than 0. When is it possible? If x does not lie between minus 4 and 8, therefore it is possible. Means x should be less than minus 4 or more than 8. Or more than 8. Then only the product is greater than 0. So x is less than minus 4, more than 8. Means fourth option is your answer. Fourth option is your answer. Next. Next one. If 1 root of ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then c equal to. Simply, 1 root is 0 means product is 0. Means c by a is 0. So c must be 0. So therefore c equal to 0. Simple answer. By mouth itself we can say c is 0. Next, 7th one. The equation whose roots are greater by 2, then those of is. He is giving one equation. Then he is asking the equation whose roots are increased by 2. Simply, he is giving f of x equal to, what is giving? 3x square minus 7x plus 4. 3x square minus 7x plus 4. He is giving f of x equal to 3x square minus 7x plus 4. And equation whose roots are greater by 2. Is equal to given. Equation of roots are greater by 2 means is asking f of x minus 2. Whenever it is asking increased by 2, then you need to find x minus 2. Automatically you will get increased by 2. If it is asking decreased by 2, you will find f of x plus 2. Automatically you will get decreased by 2. Now it is asking increased by 2. So I am taking x minus 2. So in place of x, if you substitute x minus 2, you will get equation of roots are increased by 2. Because y is equal to x plus 2, so x is equal to y minus 2. So in place of x, I am substituting y minus 2, but if it is in terms of x, that's why I am writing x minus 2. So this is 3 into x minus 2 whole square, 7 into x minus 2 plus 4. So what do I get? So 3 into x square minus 4x plus 4, a minus 2 whole square, I am expanding. And this is minus 7x plus 14 plus 4. And the final result is 3x square minus 12x minus 7x. I've read as minus 19x directly. Minus 19x. Next 3 4s are 12. 12. Next this is 14 plus 4 18. 12 plus 18 total 30. So 3x square minus 19x plus 30 is the equation whose roots are written by 2. Means third option is your answer. Given in the given options, third option is the required answer. 3x square minus 19x plus 30. Next, the equation roots are like the same, greater by 2 is asking. Whose roots are m times, means multiplied by 2, means you need to divide. If he is asking divide by 2, you need to multiply. Like the same, he is asking m times, whose roots are m times, means you need to divide by m. So given equation is, first of all, f of x equal to, what is the given equation? X square minus 2x. X square minus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. X square minus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. So I will go for m times, means I will go for x by m. So wherever x is there, I am going to substitute x by m equal to 0. Means x by m whole square minus 2 into x by m minus 3 equal to 0. If I take m square, LCM. M square I am going to take as LCM. So this is x square minus, this is 2mx minus 3m square equal to 0 is the required expression. So your option is x square minus 2mx minus 3m square equal to 0. Second option is your answer. Second option is your answer. Next, if x is real, then the least positive value of x plus 1 by x. If x is real, then least positive value of x plus 1 by x. This you can do it in two types. One is taking this is equal to y, then you know how to solve. Since x is real, this 1 minus 4 is equal to 0. Let y equal to this. So becomes x square plus 1 by x equal to y. This x, if I bring on this side, this becomes yx square. X square minus yx plus 1 equal to 0. Since x is real, this is a quadratic in x. Since x is real, we know some four marks from same method. Since x is real, b square minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0. So b square minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0 means y square minus 4 greater than or equal to 0. Means y is less than or equal, greater than or equal to 2, r less than or equal to minus 2. He is asking least positive value. Greater than or equal to 2 means 2 is the least positive value. 2 is the least positive value. This is one way of doing. Y plus 2 into y minus 2 greater than or equal to 0 means y does not multiply between minus 2 to plus 2. Means y greater than or equal to 2 or y less than or equal to minus 2. Least value is, least positive value is. As he is asking least positive value, we can go for AM and GM concept. Same sum, you can write like AM of x plus 1 by x is greater than or equal to GM of x plus x into 1 by x. That is, x into 1 by x is 1, 2 goes to the side. So x plus 1 by x greater than or equal to 2 is nothing but least value is 2. Simple, instead of doing this much. AM greater than or equal to GM. Two ways of doing. One is your regular way, four marker way. Second one is simple logic, AM GM concept. Next sum again same like previous one. X square minus 4x minus 32 less than 0. Previously that is plus for 32 and greater than 0 is giving. Now he is giving minus 32. You can do very easy. X square minus 4x minus 32 less than 0 is giving. So x square minus 4x, I will split as 8, 4 is 32. So minus 8x plus 4x minus 32 less than 0. Means x minus 8 into x plus 4 less than 0. Now we are getting less than 0. Means x lie between minus 4 and plus 4. X lie between minus 4 and plus 4. No is equal to is given, so no is equal to order. X is less than minus 4. So x lie between minus 4 to, sorry, this is 8. Lie between minus 4 and 8. So x lie between minus 4 and 8. So second option is your answer. Second option is your final answer. Next one is, as these are of same type, you can try. Next concept is, the equation with roots are 3 plus 2y, 3 minus 2y. Means how to form the quadratic equation if the roots are given. Is giving alpha equal to 3 plus 2y and beta equal to 3 minus 2y. So is giving two roots, is asking the equation. If you know the roots, you can form the equation very easily. That is, you can find alpha plus beta, alpha into beta, then form the equation. Alpha plus beta, adding these two, 3 plus 2y, 3 minus 2y, 2y plus y gets cancelled, 3 plus 3 is 6. Next, product of roots, alpha into beta, that is 3 plus 2y into 3 minus 2y. This is a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, 9 minus 4, I square is minus 1. So automatically 9 plus 4 is 13, 9 plus 4 is 13. Now therefore required equation is, x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. That is, x square minus 6x plus 13 equal to 0 is the required equation. X square minus 6x plus 13 equal to 0 is the required equation. That is third option. Third option is your answer. Next one is, alpha beta are the roots of the equation 9x square plus 6x plus 1 equal to 0. Alpha beta are the roots of the equation 9x square plus 6x plus 1 equal to 0. Then the equation whose roots are 1 by alpha comma b 1 by beta is. Then the equation whose roots are 1 by alpha comma 1 by beta is. Simply you can observe this is alpha beta roots means these are the reciprocal. So just if it is f of x, find f of 1 by x. Find f of 1 by x. Gives you reciprocal equation. So becomes 9 by x square plus 6 by x plus 1 equal to 0. If you take LCM becomes x square plus 6x plus 9 equal to 0 is the required equation. X square plus 6x plus 9 equal to 0 is the required equation. That is third option. Is the required answer. Next sum. The quadratic equation with rational quotients whose roots are 1 by 2 plus root 5. Same as previous sum. The quadratic equation whose roots are 1 by 2 plus root 5. 1 by 2 plus root 5 means if I rationalize, I will get this is root 5 is more than 2. So I will take root 5 minus 2 with the numerator and denominator, then denominator 5 minus 4 is 1. So, 1 root is giving simply root 5 minus 2. So, what should be another root? Root 5 plus 2 means minus root 5 minus 2 is the other root. I got root 5 minus 2 is root, 1 root. Like a plus root b is 1 root, a minus root b is the other root. So, a does not change because this real part means rational and this is irrational. So, rational part does not change minus 2. Irrational part, this is root 5 becomes minus root 5. So the second root is minus root 5 minus 2. Simple. This part if you understand, sum is over. So your equation is alpha plus beta, alpha into beta you need to find. That is alpha plus beta, if I add both, root 5 gets cancelled, becomes minus 4. And alpha into beta, a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, root 5 square is 5. Means, if you observe this is root 5 minus 2, into minus root 5 minus 2. If I take minus common, this is root 5 plus 2. A plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. 5 minus 4 is 1, but minus I am taking common, this becomes minus 1. This becomes minus 1. So the required equation is x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. So your equation becomes x square minus half minus plus 4x plus 4x minus 1 equal to 0. X square plus 4x plus minus 1 equal to 0. So, fourth option is your answer. Sorry, second option is your answer. Second option is your answer. Like this, we solve these type of questions. And this is how we finish with the first exercise. Tomorrow we will continue with the second exercise.